evening. I'm Jim Heath. Still more revealing news tonight concerning Governor Evan Meekum. The Arizona House of Representatives is meeting at this hour to discuss possible impeachment proceedings against the governor. Although there is no official word on what the lawmakers are deciding, Capitol reporters note the Republican support for the governor, even among House Republican leaders, is slipping. Our Linda Williams is at the Capitol, and tonight at 10, she'll have a live report. Meanwhile, county recorders across the state are busy verifying signatures on recall petitions. The recall committee submitted over 390,000 signatures to Secretary of State Rose Mofford last month, and it will be up to the county recorders to make sure there are close to 217,000 valid signatures to force a special election. The recorders will have until late January to return the petitions and the results to the Secretary of State's office. In Washington, summit prospects for President Reagan and Soviet Premier Gorbachev seem good tonight. Apparently, the final touches are being added to plans for a summit held in the U.S. early next month, but still no official word on when that summit will be. In Kenya, Ethiopian rebels are being blamed for ambushing and destroying a convoy of relief trucks carrying donated food to their fellow starving countrymen in Ethiopia. The rebels who oppose the current military government in Ethiopia doused about 450 tons of wheat with gasoline and then set the wheat on fire. In San Francisco, an AIDS-stricken teacher will return to work tomorrow. Vincent Chalk will return to the classroom after a U.S. Court of Appeals voted 3-0 in favor of Chalk's returning. School officials say Chalk will be welcomed back, but some parents have already called the school to express their concern about that decision. On the campaign trail, Vice President George Bush continues to be the Republican frontrunner for president. But in the Democratic race, Illinois Senator Paul Simon has emerged as the new leader. The latest poll in from Iowa shows Simon ahead of all other Democrats, and experts say that he's still picking up steam. But not good news tonight for former Arizona Governor Bruce Babbitt. He's still ranked at the bottom of the pack, and a new report says that Babbitt could be slipping into serious political trouble as he continues to accumulate a large financial debt. The worst snowstorm of the year continues in the Northeast. The nation's capital was hit with 15 inches of snow last night, and in New York City, JFK International Airport was closed for about 6 hours. 21 deaths so far have been attributed to that storm. On Wall Street, the Dow ended on a positive note, up 61 points. Trading was moderate to heavy. This on the same day it was announced the nation's trade deficit decreased by $1.6 billion. The debt still remains, however, at $14.1 billion. When we return, the top vacation places to put on your travel list. But first, Rick D'Amico will have the latest weather. Finally tonight, Travel and Leisure Magazine has released its annual report on where to go on your next vacation. The top five places in the world to put on your travel list: the Sundance Ski Resort in Utah, the Cayman Islands in the Caribbean, a North American vacation in either Mexico or Canada, and believe it or not, the Soviet Union. The magazine says the hotels in Russia still have a lot to be desired, but everybody wants to see how the other superpower lives. With the latest news and travel tips out of the way, thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Jim Heath. Good night.